Chapter 19. If the wonders of the world hadn't stopped at 7, Cobble's Knot would have been number 8. Nobody knew how it got there. As the story goes, the original Mr. Cobble wasn't doing too well with the original Cobble's Corner Grocery at the corner of Hector and Birch. In his first 2 weeks, all he sold was some Quaker oats and penny candy. Then one morning, he unlocked the front door for business. He saw the knot. It was dangling from the flagpole that hung over the big picture window that one said Frosted Foods in icy blue and white letters. He got out a pair of scissors and was about to snip it off when he noticed what an unusual and incredible knot it was. And then he got an idea. He could offer a prize to anyone who untangled the knot, publicize it, call the newspaper, winner's picture on the front page, Cobble's Corner in the background, business would boom. Well, he went ahead and did it. And if business didn't exactly boom, it must have at least peeped a little. Because eons later, when Maniac McGee came to town, Cobble's Corner was still there. Only now it sold pizza instead of groceries. And the prize was different. It had started out being 60 seconds alone with the candy counter. Now it was one large pizza per week for a whole year, which in time made the knot practically priceless. Which is why, after leaving it outside for a year, Mr. Cobble took it down and kept it in a secret place inside the store and brought it out only to meet a challenger. If you look at old pictures in the Two Mills times, you see that the knot was about the size and shape of a lopsided volleyball. It was made of string, but had more contortions, ins and outs, twists and turns, and dips and doodles than the brain of Albert Einstein himself. It had defeated all comers for years, including J.J. Thorndike, who grew up to be a magician, and Fingers Holloway, who grew up to be a pickpocket. Hardly a week went by without somebody taking a shot at the knot and losing. And each loser added to the glory that awaited someone who could eventually untie it. So you see, said Amanda, if you go up there and untie Cobble's Knot, which I know you can, you'll get your picture in the paper and you'll be the biggest hero ever around here and nobody will mess with you then. Maniac listened and thought about it, and finally gave a little grin. Maybe you're just after the pizza since you know I can't eat it. Amanda screeched. Jeffrey, the pizza's not the point. She started to hit him, then laughed and grabbed her wrists. He said, okay, he'd give it a try.